Boring. junk.
The woman traces glyphs in the air, and you cringe, expecting a barrage of ice and fire. Instead, a bit of smoke sputters forth. She cries to the skies in frustration, in a recognizable rail-thin rasp.
My lord, I've loved you. I've obeyed you. What's my sin? How long must I suffer?
She sees you approach and punches her fist in your direction. Her face flushes as red as your own scales. It's her, the one that destroyed the ship to Fort Joy.
You are my sin. He is the judge, and he has condemned your kind. I smell the stench of your guilt with every goddamn breath you take.
She turns her head to the heavens once more.
I offer this sacrifice to you. Return me to your side. Make me howl.
Thank you.
the only ones looking for me. But who is it? And why? boring.
Can you feel it? It is carrion and aromatic herbs, carried on the wind as one. Surely you sense it. You understand then? Ashes and bone litter the island, but where death comes, life rises. The sweetest scents flourish in the deepest tombs. Tell me, do you like roses? In that case, I think you would appreciate the blackest of roses. Look deep in the earth to the southeast, where the revolting seeds the rapturous. A dark figure wanders there. She understands these roses, why they take root. Allow the figure within to guide you, traveler. Now go, follow the wind. In a place where the dead were not allowed to rest.
Master! Master, wake up! Master, wake up!
Bones! Attack Bones! Then Sorcerer! Flash! Shiran! Bones gone!
Master, sleep! Wake up soon!
He might! Dead. Ever.
The dog is blinded by its muzzle, but it turns its face toward you, waiting for your answer. As she considers your statement, her nostrils start to twitch. She lifts her head and takes a long drag of the air around her.
Sorcerer, you! Sorcerer, you!
Kill. Dead magisters. I wonder who did this. I've spotted something.
You are floating a few inches above the ground. Your friends are impressed. You bask in their hoots and hollers. Your favorite party trick.
We leave corpses to warn you away, but still you intrude on our rest. Was I ever so stupid when I wore flesh? No matter, our master was clear. None shall pass. Guarding this land from your kind, sorcerer. Keeping to a promise that our master made. Oh, sweet thing. If you think I'll spill the tale just because you asked pretty, you'll be disappointed in this life and the next.
She reaches for her weapon.
Slave? I were a slave to Bracchus when he tore my flesh apart with his gadgets, then cursed me to guard this mire. Now I choose who I serve. I promise you, there ain't nothing you can offer that's worth more to me than what he promised. All he asks in return is I kill the occasional breather.
She looks at you with wet eyes and manages a wink before returning to her work.
Good to see you.
A bloodstained sign reads "The Hollow Marshes" in knife-scratched cursive. As you near a figure clad in old blackened armor, Sibyl takes your hand and gives it a squeeze.
I've a feeling yonder creepy crawly is the lone wolf I've been looking for. You wouldn't mind if I asked him a few pertinent questions, would you? I'll do my very, very best.
Sibyl addresses the solitary figure. You hear but whispers and hisses in return. Just when you think a fight is about to break out, Sibyl's words seem to sway him into submission.
He speaks uncomfortably. She listens, her face hard and pale. His name, you overhear her insist. Roost, he croaks. And with that, the interview's over.
Come, let's go. I have what I came for. I found out who abducted me, who delivered me to the Master. I'm going to find the man who did that, and we're going to get mightily reacquainted.
The hooded man exudes a restrained menace that near matches your own. As he raises his head, the hood falls back, revealing the gleaming bone visage of an undead.
Be not frightened of me, delicate fleshed one. There's far worse than my bite in this quagmire. Perhaps I can even offer some aid, if you've the coin. Do you desire trinkets from the ancients? For the smallest of costs, I'll tell you. Barely a trifle. I only stock the best baubles, the choicest curios. Take a look. Precious wares, are they not?
With a horrific rasp of bone scraping against bone, he bows low before you.
Call me Zalaskar. Naught else concerning me is yours to ask. My business is my own, and none of it yours. You look like a one to know already. The source in you. I can smell it. I can feel it pulsing with every beat of your fragile heart. There's ones like you close by. The Seekers. I came here with them. But Magisters sank their ship. Sorcerers, like yourself, seek them out and you might find what it is that they seek. The ones that live still? Cowering in some shrine in the depths of the swamp, twiddling their bleeding thumbs. If you're lucky, maybe you'll find them before something else finds you.
He spits something dark and viscous onto the earth. You notice the little horror wriggling deep into the soil.
If the little Seekers manage to steal the Magister's ship, the Lady Vengeance, maybe I'll find a way on board. Worry not about me. I have my methods. Worry for your own self. Why, the undead, of course. We rise. We rise. There is a stirring. Have you not felt the whisper of the grave upon the winds? The covenant will be fulfilled. Glashel demisht vmashtim.
Zalaskar chuckles unpleasantly.
Not for you to know now. Worry not, short-lived one. Your fears are as useful as those of an ant astride a leaf perched atop a tidal wave.